Subscribe to Beautification channel for all craft and DIY videos. Also hit bell icon to get updates. It's totally free.
Hi guys, this is Purnima and today I'm going to show you how to make this YouTube play button pillow. These are the requirements that you're going to be needing to make this YouTube play button pillow. Make a note of all the requirements and let's get started. I have mentioned all the measurement that you have to make in the white and the red fabric. Make a note of that. I have used the soft furry cloth. You can also use any type of cloth that you might have. Make sure that they are white and red as they are the main colors of the YouTube play button. I have folded the red fabric in half and now I will trace my chart paper, the 45 centimeter by 30 centimeters. Depending upon whichever size you want your YouTube pillow to be, you can make that. Make sure that it is rectangle, and once you're satisfied with the size, just cut it using scissor. You also have to make the triangle, so I have cut that down from the chart paper and I have traced that down the same in the white. You don't have to make it twice, you just have to make it one, as it will be only on the one side. And once you're done, you have to stitch it, guys. As it is a furry cloth, you cannot glue it using a glue gun, so make sure that you are if you want to glue it, you don't want to sew it, you can use any normal fabric. You don't have to use the furry fabric because stitching is the only option with the furry cloth, which I'm using right now. So one, you have to trace the triangle in the middle where you have to place your triangle, the white play button actually. So make sure that you are tracing it exactly in the size where you have started, and it should not be very towards the right, or not to be towards the left. It needs to be exactly in the center. And once it is completely cut out, you have to place your white triangle that you have cut from the white fabric, and you have to just start stitching. Just put both the ends of the fabric together and start stitching. It's very simple. You just have to put your needle through it, and just you can make a lock stitch or you just can stitch it normally. It is completely dependent upon you. If you want to stitch it normally, then also it is fine. So I'm just using simple lock stitch and I will do it completely until I have reached the very end. Guys, you can also use normal cloth here, and you can use glue gun here or fabric cloth if you don't want to stitch, but I really like the furry cloth type of feel. That's why I use the furry cloth. These are the cloth that you generally use for software making, so you will get it easily in all the software making shops or all the craft shop, so it will be easy. You can make the pillow as big as you want or as small as you want, depending upon your size requirement. And once the triangle is completely stitched, I will take the other side and I will start doing the same. I have put both the ends together. You make sure that the good side of both the rectangle are facing towards each other, so that it takes the form of the pillow, and just start stitching it. I've just used lock stitch to start my stitch, and then I just use normal stitching to completely stitch it. Just make sure that you leave some space so that you can easily turn it down. I have left some space, as you can see, and now I've just used my hand to take it all the pillow inside out. It's very simple. You just have to use your hands to get it inside out, and as you can see, it is already starting to give a shape of YouTube play button. You can use any leftover fabric that you might have if you don't want it to be extra soft, but I use this fiber that you generally get fill for the soft toys. I have used the same fabric, and you can also use cotton if you don't want to use, or you can also use scrap cloth if you want to fill it with scrap cloth. And once you're completely satisfied with the pillow thickness, you just have to fold both the inside together and start stitching it. As it is a furry fabric, so it will the stitch won't be very much visible. If you have a red color thread, then it is very good because it won't be seen. But if you don't have the red color thread, just like I did, don't worry, it will not be seen because that's a very furry fabric, so it won't be seen. And once your stitch is done, you just cut the excess thread and it is done. Your beautiful YouTube play button is ready. And guys, this was it. This is it, how I made. I really like it. As I'm a YouTuber, I really, really, really like it. Do make it and share videos with me. If you like this video, hit like and subscribe to my channel for more awesome videos. Take care.